Hi guys, Dr. Dane here. Today I'm going to review the coronavirus vaccines that are either currently available or will be available in the near future. I will only review vaccines that have at least interim data from late stage clinical trials. And just so you all know, I don't have any conflicts of interest with any of the pharmaceutical companies that I will be discussing. For this video, I will reply to all well-intentioned comments, but make sure you like and subscribe to the channel if you like what I'm doing or you found this helpful. COVID-19, a novel and potentially deadly virus that has spread throughout the globe. This virus was first identified in China, but now has many different strains that have developed over time. For example, we have the UK variant, or more specifically, variant B.1.1.7, or the South African variant, B.1.351, or the Brazilian variant, P1. Vaccines are essential for slowing the spread of this virus because they reduce the potentially susceptible population. The vaccines we have for COVID work in various different ways. We'll cover this in some detail, but basically, they work because the human body recognizes the COVID-19 spike protein and subsequently develops antibodies to help protect us from COVID-19 infection. I will explain how these vaccines work with the help of images published by the New York Times, so shout out to them for creating such awesome images. However, don't be overwhelmed by the details. I merely want to show how there are various different ways for creating vaccines against the coronavirus. So without further ado, let's jump into it. To start with, let's talk about the mRNA vaccines. The Pfizer vaccine was produced by Biotech, a German biotechnology company, whereas the Moderna vaccine was made by Moderna, an American pharmaceutical company. Their vaccines both received emergency use authorization by the FDA in December. Their vaccines consist of COVID-19 mRNA that is wrapped in a lipid nanoparticle barrier that protects the mRNA before it reaches a target cell. The mRNA is then translated into the spike protein. Next, we have the viral vector vaccines, which use an adenovirus vector to enable the COVID-19 DNA to enter the target cells. One of these vaccines is produced by the Gamaleya Institute in Russia, another by AstraZeneca, a British and Swedish pharmaceutical company, and the other by Belgian Janssen Pharmaceutica, which is owned by Johnson & Johnson. As shown in the image, the adenovirus vector enables the COVID-19 DNA to reach the nucleus of the cell in our bodies, enabling the synthesis of the spike protein. The third category involves a vaccine manufactured by Novavax, an American vaccine development company. This vaccine consists of multiple spike protein subunits surrounded by an adjuvant, which is basically a chemical that is used to attract immune cells. Our body's immune cells are then able to mount an immune response once they encounter the spike protein. Finally, we have a vaccine synthesized by Bharat Biotech, an Indian biotechnology company. This vaccine, named COVAXIN, was made by inactivating a live coronavirus specimen with chemicals to ensure that it cannot replicate while keeping its structure intact. Like the Novavax vaccine, it interacts directly with the body's immune cells, resulting in an immune response. This rounds out the list of vaccines I am covering in this video. Of note, several vaccines have been produced in China that are currently in use, although I have not included them here given the lack of publicly available data on them. There are a few important factors that consumers need to consider when evaluating a coronavirus vaccine. These include safety, efficacy, effectiveness, coverage for variants, the dosing schedule, and the cost. Efficacy, the percentage reduction of disease in a vaccinated group of people compared to an unvaccinated group in a clinical trial. Effectiveness, how a vaccine actually performs in the real world. Coverage for variants, is the vaccine protective against other strains of the coronavirus? Dosing schedule, how many shots are needed to complete the vaccine schedule and how much time is needed between those shots for persons to be completely vaccinated. Safety, the risk and severity of side effects potentially caused by the vaccine. And cost, how much will it cost the consumer to be vaccinated? There are other considerations that governments have to think about when evaluating a coronavirus vaccine. However, I will discuss these in an upcoming video. Here is a table comparing the vaccines on a few key characteristics. A couple of things to note here. The Pfizer, Moderna, Gamaleya, and Novavax vaccines have all reported efficacy above 90%, while most companies have reported efficacy in terms of reduction in cases of symptomatic disease. Johnson & Johnson have reported the efficacy in terms of reduction of moderate to severe disease, which is usually a higher number. The vaccines from Pfizer and AstraZeneca have caused significant reductions in COVID-19-related hospitalizations in communities that have been immunized. The AstraZeneca and Novavax vaccines have shown decent efficacy against the UK variant, and all of the vaccines require two doses aside from the one by Johnson & Johnson. Notice that I have not commented on the safety and cost of these vaccines because they all have excellent safety profiles, as far as we know, and most countries are providing these vaccines to its citizens for free. Make sure you check out the references in the video description below for more complete details regarding these vaccines. So, which vaccine should you choose? Essentially, whichever vaccine you can get your hands on. We need to control the spread of this virus as soon as possible. It's also likely that you may not even have a choice of which vaccine to take due to regional variations in what is approved for use and available in your area. However, if you do have a choice, consider the above-mentioned factors when selecting which coronavirus vaccine to take. One caveat though, the information on how well a vaccine works is ever-changing and may be different in a few weeks' time. In summary, we are blessed to have so many excellent vaccines available to help fight this infection, and many more coming down the pipeline. A huge thank you to those in vaccine development that have made this the case. If you found this video helpful, make sure to like and subscribe. I would also love to hear your comments below regarding your thoughts on this topic. Anyway, until next time.